Muhammad Yunus, the Nobel laureate, rose to fame with his Grameen Bank. He was born in 1940. He is an author, economist, founder of Grameen Bank, lays focus on microcredit and microfinance, and was listed as one of the 12 top business leaders by Times magazine and one of the 25 most influential business persons of the past 25 years by Wharton School of Business. Muhammad Yunus was born on 28 June 1940 in the village of Batua in Hatazari, Chittagong, Bangladesh. His father worked as a jeweler and mother was a housewife, but he considered his mother as a role model. His mother's name was Sophia Khatun. Yunus' parents moved to Chittagong when he was only 4 years old. In 1955, Yunus developed interest in Boy Scouts and got a chance to travel to Canada to attend a jamboree. It had a great impact on him. He performed well in school and got 16th rank among 39,000 students. After high school, he studied at Dhaka University and got the BA degree in 1960 and MA degree in 1961. His first job was of a research assistant, and later he became a lecturer in economics in Chittagong College. In 1965, Yunus received Fulbright scholarship to study economics at Vanderbilt University, completed his PhD there, and remained in the US as an assistant professor of economics at Middle Tennessee State University for 3 years from 1969 to 1972. However, in 1971, India and Pakistan engaged in Bangladesh Liberation War, which lasted for 9 months. And at that time, Yunus was in USA. He thought of helping his Bangladeshi friends and therefore set up an information center in US to raise support for liberation. After war, Yunus returned to Bangladesh and joined Chittagong University, acting as head of the department. After his return to Bangladesh in the year 1974, Bangladesh suffered famine, which was accompanied by flood. And at that time, the country received no relief from other countries and people suffered from starvation. Yunus was profoundly affected by this and he became actively involved in poverty reduction. He established a rural economic program as a research project because he wanted to know the scope of damage caused by famine. In 1976, as part of his programs, Yunus got a chance to visit the poorest households. And there, he interviewed a woman who used to make bamboo stools. He learned that she was charged exorbitant rates for her loans and thus was barely making profit. He decided to give the loan equivalent to $27 to 42 women. This was his first ever loan which he gave. And it was here that Yunus realized that microfinance and microcredit could help Bangladesh. Yunus knew that traditional banks would not be interested in loans of smaller values. Therefore, he applied for a loan from the government Janata Bank to set up his own institution to lend money. And by the end of 1976, he got loan and set up to work. His institution put into practice the microcredit model. By 1982, Grameen Bank expanded to 28,000 members. In 1983, Grameen Bank got its status as fully fledged bank. And in 1990, the bank started to diversify. It now focused on irrigation schemes, equity projects, and telecommunications. Grameen Phone became the biggest private sector phone company in Bangladesh, supplying over 250,000 phones to the poor across 50,000 villages. By 2007, Grameen Bank had issued over $6 billion to more than 7 billion borrowers. And the repayment of loans was ensured through solidarity groups. These solidarity groups were small groups where the people would apply together for a loan and the members within a group would support one another to ensure repayment and self-advancement. Nearly 95% of Grameen loans were given to women. Grameen Bank alleviated poverty and empowered women. Because of the success of Grameen Bank, Muhammad Yunus got to serve in the Advisory Council for Sustainable Economic Development. He served in the UN Expert Group on Women and Finance and became member of the International Advisory Board for the Fourth World Conference on Women. He also served on the Global Commission of Women's Health. He was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize, won the Presidential Medal of Freedom. US President Bill Clinton was an ardent supporter of Yunus, and Yunus methods are now used in 60 countries. This 80-year-old economist has faced his own share of struggles. In 2007, he made a brief foray into the country's politics and started courting controversies. In 2013, he faced legal action against him, and in 2015 was summoned by court. He had to give up his job as the managing director of Grameen Bank. However, he will always be seen as an individual who led the fight against poverty. In his own words, "I am encouraging young people to become social business entrepreneurs and contribute to the world rather than just making money. Making money is no fun. Contributing to and changing the world is a lot more fun."